I have the senior franchise brand manager of Coca-Cola Kenya, Rodney Nzioka. How do you feel about this news? What are 202 up, Ivo? How do you feel about this news?
Yemurino.
Yes.
It's very exciting. Very, very exciting. Though as a Arsenal fan, I think I'd have liked him to stay a bit longer.
So that he gets to go to relegation.
It was good entertainment.
You're so evil. Karibu sana. Of course, I've brought Rodney here because Rodney is recently awarded a very important historic trophy to the under-16 Kenyan team during the, of course, under-16 Africa Cup of Nations that was held in Afraha Stadium, the finals.
Yeah.
And we're here to find out exactly what this tournament is about. You don't know. I'm sure you will ishtuka tu kaangalia ni aje. So, Ron, why this particular event? Why this age group and why at this particular time?
Well, the reason we focus on under-16 as Coca-Cola is because that is the best part, is the best time to actually develop the raw talent. That's the age at which you discover that you actually have a gift, whether it's in basketball, music, football, whatever talent it is that you have. And that's the best part and point to give the platform to players to nurture their talents. Mm-hmm. So as Coca-Cola, we've been doing Copa Coca-Cola in Kenya for the past 10 years. It's been focused on under-16, focused on the high schools, and we've been building it for the past 10 years, and now it's got to that point where we're like, we need to take it now to the next level, which is where now we've gone continental and made it even bigger.
How did you come to select these particular teams? Mm-hmm. And of course, there was Kenya, there was Nigeria, yeah, and we're very happy to beat Nigeria. I mean, it was some. How did you end up, of course, inviting? Bona Muku invite Ethiopia.
No, Ethiopia.
Ama South Sudan.
Ethiopia were there.
Ama Chad.
Actually, we played them in the first
Mauritius
game.
And you hammered Ethiopia by 11.
Yeah. Yes. Now, Copa Coca-Cola is a Coca-Cola asset that is run in over 30 countries in Africa. What that means is that every year there's an overall Copa Coca-Cola champion in each of the countries. So what we did this for the Copa Africa Cup, we invited the winners of all the countries. So now due to either schedules, getting papers or visas to be able to travel in, not all 30 plus countries were able to make it for the first edition, but we got 12 to make it. So now our challenge for 2019 is now to make it even bigger and better with more countries, more girls teams, more boys teams to make it a truly, truly continental tournament.
2019, yeah, you've mentioned about it. So what is in store for 2019? Or that is still under the tables or still under being construction?
Well,
which countries, yes.
Well, which countries will participate is now, we'll see now progress. But we do know that Copa Coca-Cola Africa Cup is going to happen in 2019 and in 2020 and in 2021. It's going to be an annual tournament. That's our commitment to football, to developing football on the continent.
Definitely. Yeah. And of course, there must be motivation. Of course, when players are playing for the under 16, they're looking forward to maybe joining the other ahead edge structure.
Yes.
Your objectives in terms of now perhaps building the football, because this is good, of course, starts from the grassroots and looks for those who are still young.
Right. So it's twofold. Number one, we want to make it, especially during the tournament, it's more than just about the football. Think about it. These are teens who it's the first time they've probably even left their village. Forget, they've not even gone to the capital city. So they get to the capital city, then get on a plane, and then come to Kenya. So that already in itself is an experience. So we're providing something that they may not have been able to experience it, but now they have through the football. And then we're equipping them now with different skills as they're playing during the tournament. They're playing an organized game with proper referees, proper equipment. They're interacting with teams from other cultures. They're doing cultural exchange. They're learning discipline, teamwork, leadership, all vital skills that are important as they grow older in their football careers. But also more importantly, we also have, during the week, we had scouts and coaches from other teams who are there watching these players. And the reason why that's important is because we can confidently say Kenya has recently qualified for the AFCON. We have a couple of players who are in that team who actually passed through Copa Coca-Cola and were picked up by scouts. You know, we have names like Ovela Ochieng, Eric Johanna, Michael Olunga. All these are players who passed through the Copa system. And now that we're making it more than just Kenya, we're making it a continental tournament, there's even more opportunity to get these young players into local leagues, into continental leagues, and someday into the superstar leagues to hopefully not be coached by Mourinho.
So at least they won't just, after this tournament, of course, they didn't go to their villages and just get stuck there for Christmas. Wakai.
No.
I'm sure there's a follow-up mechanism that, of course, you put in place together with the coaches and the other...
And the scouts, correct. So they're the scouts. There's a scout side of thing, but then there's also the experience that they're taking back. They got to come to Kenya and to Nakuru, which is one of the most tourist, beautiful tourist destinations. So it was more than just the football. So they have an experience that they're going to take with them for a lifetime, and we look forward to seeing what they do with it going forward.
So are we going in future, Coca-Cola, to start something, a World Cup of your own sort of World Cup? I know you brought the trophy to us.
Yes.
And definitely, I'm sure those are some of the things you're looking forward to.
Come work for Coca-Cola. That's a good idea. No, but seriously, what we actually wanted to do, and that's why this is a first step. We want to make this our Africa World Cup, our under-16 COPA Coca-Cola Africa Cup. So we want to get more teams participating. And who knows, in the future, because COPA is an asset that is played in Europe, in South America, in North America, who knows, we may be able to get it to that level where we actually are playing against, we're sending an Africa All-Star team to play against South America or to play against Europe. So it's something that's in the plans. It's something we want to work forward to, but we want to make sure that we have developed the Africa Cup to the fullest extent and the fullest capability that it can deliver. That's our focus now.
Most definitely. You mentioned about coming to Coca-Cola. I'll give you my CV on your way out. Of course, it's run in Nzioka. Of course, the brand is a senior franchise brand manager.
Yeah.
Hey, Eugene, I'm sure there are other things I've left out.
Maybe.
Of Coca-Cola Kenya. About this particular tournament as well. So the children who are going through this, do we have blessings from the Football Kenya Federation? I'm sure you have. There was, of course, we had the secondary school association.
Correct.
Ngugi David was there.
Yes.
Do we have blessings from the FK? Of course, sometimes in Afikanga Mali, then things just crumble down because, there was what and what and
what. Right. You see, in this scenario, we actually don't go through the FKF because this is high school football, right? So the high school football is run by the Kenya Secondary School Sports Association, which is mandated by the Ministry of Education to execute it. So it's not an FKF decision. However, we do welcome, discussions and partnerships with them, because going forward, we want to be able to get COPA to a level where it becomes a feeder program into the under-17 national team, into the local league. So obviously we'll need multiple stakeholders to come to the table. So we're definitely open to discuss it.
What are the cash, what are people taking home? Now that's under-16, alienda nyumbani, alibeba nini, okay, besides the hampers and stuff, mulu wapate nini wapeleke nyumbani. Because I'm sure they're watching and saying, wacha tuone kama atasema ukweli on air.
But you know the answer. It's under-16. Cash is not something that we give to high school students. Ours, again, is the focus on the experience and ensuring that they have a life-changing time in Kenya. They got the best quality education, the best quality football facilities. They played against high quality players in Nigeria, Angola, Ethiopia, all the other teams that were there. And they got to learn something new about other cultures. They got something to learn something new about themselves. They challenged themselves, and they've grown as individuals. That, for us, would be the biggest reward if that's what they've taken away.
Most definitely. Yeah. Very important. I hope I've not left out anything. But of course, if anyone, next year, how are we going to get our... Because you see, we have 40... Let's say we have like 10 million youth under 16.
Correct.
Selection. So you match that one, you left Kina David Ngugi with the KSS to select the team that will go to, I don't know, next year you're taking to where?
No, now what happens is we play the Copa Coca-Cola in Kenya, right? And this, in 2018, the winners were St. Anthony's from Kakamega. So that was our selection. That was because you as St. Anthony's are the ones who won the overall Copa Coca-Cola tournament in Kenya, you become the Kenya representative. It's as simple as that. There's no all-star team or anything behind the scenes. It's as simple as winning Copa Coca-Cola.
Most definitely. Yeah. St. Anthony Kitale.
Kitale.
Should be Kitale. Yes, St. Anthony Kitale. They won it last time, of course. My Kakamega and Kitale. Thank you so much, Rodney.
Thank you for having me.
That was good. I mean, definitely, this is, of course, a challenge to the high schools. Yeah. You know exactly what to do. You know what you need to be preparing yourself for. Because, of course, next year, you can imagine, Coca-Cola brought the World Cup trophy to Kenya, just before the 2018 Russia World Cup. I mean, so they have the muscle and the power to carry an entire team, out of the entire school, like St. Anthony, wapeleke Nigeria, ama wapeleke South Africa, wacheze football. What are you waiting for? So next season, and then kufanyeni mazoezi sahi ya football.
Yes.
Kakamega High School, St. Mukumu, watu wa wapi huko Central, watu wa Mombasa, you know what to do. This is a good exposure. You can imagine playing in South Africa and you're under 16 and being selected. What more would you want?
More.
K24 Sports Hub, we bring you the people who matter. And thank you so much, Coca-Cola, Rodney Nzioka, who is, of course, the senior franchise brand manager of Coca-Cola Kenya.
Yes, Kenya.
Munabaki Kenya bado.
Munabaki Kenya.
Munasikia mofisi munafunga.
Ah, pana. How? We're still everyone, when you stop
so
drinking
soda. So CV ni later.
Let us CV. Kwaza nitatoka nayo sasa.
Thank you very much, Coca-Cola, for your, of course, your ambassadors come to share very detailed information about the Africa Cup of Nations under 16 history making. Of course, St. Anthony Kitale winning it. We also won it in the girls category. Wako na prizes nyumbani sasa mna smile hata mnaniangalia. That's why nilivaa tie ya. Hata sisemi pia Rodney pia amedunga kitu kana ka hivi. Thank you so much. This, of course, is K24 Sports Hub. We are supposed to take your calls and your feedback in the mob, but due to time, thank you. Tomorrow is another day. Good afternoon. My name is Tony Kolanda.